There's data coming through faster than I can encode it. I've already lost two processors. They keep burning out.
Please, I love you. You need to get out of there. It's not safe.
I need you, Steven. I need you here. I can open the gate manually. I can let you in.
It's too dangerous. You don't understand what's happening
out
here.
No, you don't understand. We can solve this. We can find a way. I just need more power. I need to amplify the signal, and I can't do it on my own. You saw the opportunity. You ran the numbers, remember?
We're responsible for all this. You and me.
It's not just you and me anymore, though, is it?
Jesus, Kate, you're trying to talk to it, aren't you? Kate, you can't.
Steven, I have to.
Completely dead. It won't start.
It's only a short walk to the camp. I think we should split up. You go and fetch Rachel. I'll go back to the village and find Evie.
I don't think we should split up.
I don't want to either, Charlie, but we've got to. I'll meet you back at my house later on, okay? We can talk properly then.
Why won't you tell me what happened?
No, actually, you should stay at the camp tonight. Come and find me in the morning. Bring Rachel back. She's going to need her mother.
Meg.
Just take care of her.
Meg!
What is it, Charlie?
Nothing. Just be careful.
I will, I promise. You as well. I'll see you later on.
Why on earth are you there? Why aren't you calling from home?
It's hard to explain. I'm having to move around to follow it. When it finds a suitable host, it begins to amplify. Sorry, I'm not making much sense.
They're talking about flu and a quarantine on the radio, but this... I know you're not that kind of doctor, but it all just sounds really weird.
We don't know exactly what it is yet, but it's got something to do with the other night.
Stephen, your face, the mark. Do you think you're infected?
It's not a disease, Lizzie. It's something else. There's something Kate said about patterns. I can't grasp it clearly yet.
Okay, come over. Have some lunch. We can talk properly. Have you spoken with Kate?
Well, she's locked herself in the observatory. She's buried in the data. But it's already out here in the world. I need to see how it adapts.
How what adapts? Stephen, try to explain.
Lizzie, listen. Be ready. I need to go. It's moving again. I'll call you later.
Do you think she'll like it?
It's in an awful state, Stephen. I don't think so.
It'll be an adventure. It'll mean putting down roots here, maybe a family.
Are you sure she wants children? What, to stay here? It's not her place, you know.
Don't start that again, please.
I mean, she's ambitious, love, and she's, well, older. She's not going to want to stay cooped up at home looking after the kids.
Is that how you felt about me?
Oh, stop it, Stephen. That's not what I meant, and you know it. I'm just saying you should make a choice. If it's a family you want, well, you know how much Lizzie wants a family.
Jesus, Mum, I didn't come here for marriage guidance. I just asked what you thought about a fucking house.
Stephen Appleton, language!
Sorry, it's just that you have to understand. Kate is the most brilliant, extraordinary, wonderful person I've ever known. She's like no one else. The way she looks at things, it's like she has whole worlds inside her head. I don't think you or anyone really understands that.
Physical changes are evident. Although the butterfly burn is now faded, I can clearly see the change in my pores up close. As I record these words, I can feel myself hearing them as if for the first time, as if I'm both speaker and listener simultaneously. I am a scientist. I can only deal with the evidence I have. And this points in one simple direction. It's not in the observatory.
can you hear me? Listen, I'm trying to make things right. I've isolated myself. I'm in the old bunker at the substation. Just keep this band clear. If you're still alive, I'll try and check in every hour. Kate, I've convinced them to use the gas. I didn't know how else to stop it. I couldn't save them. Kate, it's in us, too. I've made arrangements for myself after the strike, after I finish the job. You need to think of that, too. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry about it all.
You know the protocol.
That doesn't matter now. It's figured out how to circumvent the telecommunications blackout.
What?
I didn't think it could. Kate understood. She saw how adaptable it was. How smart.
Jesus Christ, you're talking about it like it's alive.
You have to assume that everyone here is infected.
We can't know
that. We're infected. It's killed all the birds, and now it's in us. It's trying to leave the valley any way it can. The quarantine is not enough. You've got to remove the carriers. You've got to cut off its energy source, its food.
I've already told you, Stephen, I'm not going to water an airstrike.
You have to. Now it knows we're onto it, it's going to keep on spreading as fast as it can.
The quarantine and blackout will hold it in check. They've cut all of the phones out of the valley, so it's only you communicating out now.
Are you listening? It's figured out ways around it. Radio waves, something. All of the lines are cut, but the phones are working anyway. You've done all the right things, but it's not enough. You've got to stop it before it adapts again.
Stephen, my family, my wife and kids.
You know perfectly well what you've got to do.
I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it. You're asking me to sign their death warrant, my own family.
Damn it, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff. Don't you lecture me about sacrifice, you spineless little shit. If you're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them the time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now.
Thank you.
You look well.
I don't. But thank you. You do. How are you settling in?
Nothing changes around here. I mean, it's great to be back. It still feels like home, I suppose. In a funny kind of way.
It's been a long time, Stephen. Last time you saw me, I could still walk properly.
You look pretty good to me.
Stop it.
For what it's worth, I'm sorry about how things worked out.
Or didn't.
Or didn't, right.
Do you think you made a mistake leaving?
My mum tells me it's never too late to change things, to put things right.
Funny. It's just what she said to me the other day. I have been wondering what she meant by that.
That's embarrassing. Sorry.
Maybe I should go.
Why?
Stephen, we're both married. I don't think this is a good idea.
What isn't? We're just two old friends having a drink, that's all.
Pressure in my eyes again. I can't move my legs, can't feel my face. When I collapsed, the light was waiting for me there. Caught me, lowered me here. Now it's pooling around my feet, watching me. The printers are spewing out page after page of zeros. It's frightened, too. It'll be okay. I'll look after you. It's alone. It's scared. Oh, it's traveled so far. It's okay. I can help you. We can be together now. 10 seconds to signal fusion. We can be together. 3 seconds.
They closed the tunnel.
There's no trains. I've put up a sign.
The tunnel, Howard. Is it closed?
I think so. I don't like it. It's not right at all.
Stop whining. It doesn't help anyone. Did you know you're bleeding?
Oh, it's this headache. It's just killing me. I haven't had a nosebleed like this since I was a kid.
But you've not been to the village?
No, I've been here the last couple of days or at home. I've only spoken to Clive at the EMC on the phone. Well, tried to anyway, but with all the crossed lines...
But no direct contact with any other people?
No, no one. What are you talking about? What's going on?
It's the pattern. It's adapted again. It doesn't need direct contact to transfer. It's using the phones!
What do you mean, direct contact? Stephen!
I've never seen it.
They do, though.
You're overreacting.
Steven, they stare at me. Yesterday, I went into the village, and this old woman just stopped in the middle of the street and stared at me like I had two heads.
Oh, don't be so melodramatic.
I'm like a walking freak show. Oh, this place, it's so insular. I just don't understand how you grew up here.
Well, I was very different then. And they're not so bad, really.
That's easy for you to say.
Just give it a bloody chance, Kate. This was the deal. A year here, and we could be in with a real shot at Lassia.
Steven!
Oh, Christ, it's Lantham.
Steven Appleton, I thought it was you. What's all this about a Yank wife? Oh. Hello.
Two heads, Steven. Hi, I'm Kate.
Darling Stephen, I don't know if you'll ever listen to this. Maybe you've decided to stay with Kate, and I can't blame you for that. But I can't wait for you either. I've got to think about the baby. And, well, I should have left a long time ago. I've run out of excuses for not leaving now. But I do love you, Stephen. And I hope you find peace one way or another. Oh, there's planes coming.